Sexual reproduction in plants, and in plants flower is essential parts of sexual reproduction. Now here today we are taking one hibiscus or shoe flower. In this shoe flower there are four important holes in the flower from outside to inside, namely calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium, from outside to inside. Now out of these four important holes, the two, they are divided into the two important holes are there. Number one is what? Outer holes and inner holes. Outer holes are calyx and corolla. They are called as accessory holes. They are called as what?
Accessory
holes. And the inner holes, that is called as essential holes. They are only taking part in the reproduction. What are those holes? Number one, androecium, and number two,
gynoecium.
Now we are taking dissection of this flower and we are making the various parts in this tray. So here we can see very easily the whole flower will be here. It is hibiscus flower. Now it says having total four holes. Now first hole outside, it is called as calyx. Generally it is green in color. They have sepals. Alright. And what is the function of this calyx? To protect the inner parts. Now second is corolla. Corolla is second inner or outer membrane or outer part of the flower. And it is colorful, multicolor. It attracts the insect for the pollination or fertilization. Now the third, that is essential holes, it is called as androecium, and androecium is made from anther and
filament.
It is a male reproductive organ in plants or flowers. And here the last one is called as gynoecium. This gynoecium contain the stigma, upper part, the style and the ovary. All these three made the gynoecium. Gynoecium and androecium are essential holes. They are only taking part in the reproduction. So this is all information about the parts of flower. I think you are very easily understand these parts of flower. Okay.